Hello everyone, and welcome to SQLBits 2020, the greatest data show on earth. And welcome to my session. Today, I'm going to talk about Azure Key Vault, Azure DevOps, and Azure Data Factory, and how these Azure services can work perfectly together. My name is Aaron de Kruik, and I'm working as a principal consultant for Inspark. At Inspark, we help organizations accelerating their digital transformation with impactful Microsoft solutions and expertise. Today, I'm going to use three Azure Data services. The first one we're going to use today is Azure Data Factory. Hopefully, most of you have used this great service. What can do Azure Data Factory is a hybrid data integration service. You can build with visual tools, you can build, debug, deploy, and monitor your data pipelines and also your big data pipelines. It's an easy way to provide a way to transform data at scale and without any coding required ELT platform, so the extract, load and transform platform. And even with the new functionalities like mapping data flow, running data flow, it's very easy to do a lot of transformations without really C# or .NET code. The second service we're going to use today is DevOps. And I always like this statement. This is a great statement from Donovan Brown. DevOps is the union of people, processes, and products to enable continuous delivery of value to your end users. Most of you have probably used Azure DevOps before. Within Azure DevOps, we have a couple of components. The Azure Boards, where you can define your Scrum or Agile way of working. With the Plan Boards, we have the Azure Pipelines, which we are going to use today. And there are two separate pipelines, the build pipelines to build your code and the release pipelines to deploy your code to a next environment. Azure Repos, the version control, the integrated version control of Azure DevOps. Azure Test Plans is really a great feature to test your code before you build or before you release your code to a next step. And the last one are the Azure Artifacts. So you can deploy code to this artifact and other developers can use this code to integrate it in their code again. And the last one is a great feature. There are a lot of extensions available on the marketplace which can be used to everybody to extend a lot of new components to your Azure DevOps environment. And the last service today I'm going to talk about is the Azure Key Vault. Azure Key Vault is a great service which you really should use to store your keys. The Azure Key Vault is a safe house to safeguard the cryptographic keys and secrets that are used for that you are using in your applications, servers, connection strings, and a cloud application. It's fully integrated with Azure Active Directory, and there are three components defined. You can define secrets, you can define the keys, and the certificates. In Azure Key Vault, there are a couple of roles defined. You have the people from the security operations, they can manage the keys, they can create a Key Vault, but they also can add keys and secrets to that Key Vault. And very important, they can grant permissions to specific applications to perform the operations of these using the keys. And I will show you later on in the demo how that will work. And he or she can also enable users logs. The second role is a developer. The only thing the developer needs to know is the URI of the key of the secret. That's URI he can integrate in his application, and then he can use the key or the secret, or maybe abuse that key, but he will never see the key. So if I give him a secret, he can use that, but with what's in the secret, so the connection string, the username, the password, he will never see that. The last one is the auditor. The auditor can access the keys, but he can also monitor everything and review these logs. If the keys are used properly and if they are compliant with the security standards within your company. So enough about the three services, let's start. Today we need to create an Azure Data Factory and we are going to create two environments, one for development and one for our test environment. Each environment has a SQL database as a source and a blob store as a destination. These services can be created through the Azure portal, but also to PowerShell scripts, which you can see on the screen. Within the Azure Data Factory, I'm always using naming conventions. So we have a transparent and a dynamically environment overall. So for this today, for this Data Factory, I'm using Demo ADK as a customer name, Azure, of course, from the Azure environment, DVLM from the environment, so development or test in the other, on the other side, ADF as the as a service, and BICC 01 as the department and data factory number one. The second step is, once we have created our data factory, is that we want to connect that data factory to our Azure DevOps repository. So that's very easy to do. Once you have clicked on the button Setup Code Repository, you will see a new screen where you can select the repository type. You can choose between the Azure DevOps Git or GitHub. In this case, we are going to use the Azure DevOps Git. A new screen will pop up and you have to define a couple of components here. You can select the Azure Active Directory, because your Azure Active Directory can also be another Active Directory. The only thing you may have to make sure that both accounts exist in both Active Directories. Then you can select your Azure DevOps account, the project name. We're going to create today a new repository name. The collaboration branch, we leave it for today on master, and we will import our existing data factory resources to the repository. So everything you already have created in your data factory will be deployed to your Azure DevOps environment. The next step we need to do is to create some linked services today, one for the Azure SQL database and also one for the blob storage. Also here, you will see, once you have created these, that they will directly be saved in the Azure DevOps environment. And also, I'm using naming conventions here. DLS for the linked servers, ASQL for the Azure SQL database, the environment, 01 for the logical server, and the worldwide importers for the database. More naming conventions can be found on my website, and it's really easy to use. Once we have created the linked services, we need to create some data sets. We have to define which data we're going to extract from our source and what will be the destination of that data. So once we have created these data sets, we can publish them to our DevOps environment. And I will show you how that works during the demo a little bit later. The next step is that once we have deployed these components, you will see that a new directory is created in our Azure DevOps environment called ADF Publish. And the ARM template for factory will be there, and the ARM template parameter for factory will be there, which we're going to use later on for our deployment pipelines or release pipelines. The last step we're going to do during the demo is that we are going to create a pipeline where we have to define our source, so that's the SQL database from the Wide World Importer database, and our sync, that's our blob storage. And in between, we will make sure that we copy the data from A to B. So how that everything works, I will show you right now during my demo. So what I will do, I will log in to my Azure environment. And if you can see, I have already created some resources. So I have created the data factory, the SQL database, or the SQL server with the database, and the blob storage. And the same for the test environment. So I will open my data factory. I will click on the audit and monitor part, and my data factory will open. I have to log in. And you will see that I have here my data factory. I can create pipelines, data flows from templates. I can copy data. I can configure the SGS integration, but I can also start to set up my code repository. Let's start to do that. So once I've clicked there, I can choose between these two environments. Now, what I already told you before, we're going to use the Azure DevOps Git today. I'm going to select my Active Directory. Then I'm going to select my account, the project name, and I'm going to use, for example, SQL Bits as my repository name. I leave it on master, I leave the root file like it is, and I'm going to import the existing data factory resources to the repository. Once I clicked on apply, it will check all the information, it will save the information to my DevOps environment, and everything is created in my DevOps environment. So if I go here to my DevOps environment, I will open that one. I'm going to the repos. And once you will see, I've created a SQL Bits directory. And as you can see, the last change was just now. And all the data sets I have created before are already in there. So if I go back to my data factory, I'm going to my linked servers, you will see I have created one Wild World Importers, with the connection string, the passwords, and the username. And I have also here the blob storage. And once I change something in here, for example, I do this blob storage of this copy purchase orders, I change the name, and I'm going to save that and I'm going to publish that. You will see that we have will get, oh, click it away, publishing. ADF publish will be created and it will all be published in our DevOps environment in the ADF publish branch. Let me check over here. As you can see, the DevOps, the Data Factory engine, the template, and the template parameter for the factory. So these files we are going to use in the later stage. So switching back to the presentation. So what we have done, we have created our Azure Data Factory in our development environment. We have created a connection for our database and we have created a connection to our blob storage and we have created the connection to our DevOps environment. The next step is that we need to create our key vault so we can start using our key our keys within the data factory. So what we are going to do, we are going to create that Azure Key Vault live in a database. I'm always creating that in an, yeah, we call it DTAP environment, but that's a central environment. So I'm only creating one Key Vault, which I can use for my development environment, also for my test environment. And you can also create that Key Vault within your, with a PowerShell script. The next step is that we need to create that new service within our data factory to make that key vault available to use within the data factory. And as you can see below, you have the grant data factory managed identity access to your key vault. That's an option which you can directly do when you create your new key vault. Once we have created that key vault, we we can start creating our secrets. So for today, we need to create some secrets for our development environment for the blob storage and some secrets for our test environment, also for our blob and for the SQL environment. Also here, I'm using naming conventions and that's really easy, like for the environment to use then later on dynamically set up functionality within our Azure Key Vault or Azure DevOps environment. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch over to my screen over here and I'm going to make a more great demo regarding this key vault. So the first step is what we need to do is we need to create that key vault. So we're going to the dashboard and once we are in the dashboard, I'm just going to open the template I'm using here, which is easy to create. So I'm going to that resource group and I'm going to add a key vault. So I'm going to search in the marketplace for that key vault. I'm going to click on create. Data in AI. I'm going to select West Europe. Europe, where are you? West Europe. I'm going to select the standard policy, standard pricing tier, and what I just explained to you, I'm going to directly add the access policy. So what I will do, I will grant my data factory get access to the keys or to the secrets. So I'm going to look here for demo ADK, select the development environment, select, and I'm going to add. The next step is to create that key vault. Create and now the key vault is created. Going back to our data factory and we go back to the connections and we're going to create that new link server. So also here I'm going to search for the key vault and hopefully in the meantime the key vault is created. It's a link server with the naming conventions Azure Key Vault. Oh, it's already filled in. the description I can leave, from which subscription, the key vault name. Do I have already that demo over there? Yes, you can see. And as what I did before, don't forget to grant your access. And we can test if it is working correctly or not. Yes, it's working. So that means that our key vault has been created in our environment, as you can see. So the next step is, in our Azure Key Vault, we need to assign some keys, or we need to create some keys in our Key Vault. So I'm going back to my dashboard. I'm going to the just created, newly created Key Vault engine. I'm going to secrets, and I'm gonna add some new secrets. I've prepared that on my screen. So what I have to do, I have to create a secret like you see over here for my development environment, for the blob storage, and for that environment. And I will copy in the correct key. So yeah, sorry, this is a little bit of work I need to do in front. I'm gonna create also one for my test environment. Don't know what is happening over here, but like this, and then the key create, and I'm going to get a new one for my SQL environment. Don't know why it is happening that he is pre-filling everything, but it doesn't matter. So you're not allowed to use spaces, so I'm going to change that later on. So now I have created these secrets for you, and now we can start assigning these secrets to our connections in Data Factory and to see if I filled them in correctly. So I'm going back to my Data Factory, I'm going to my blob storage, and I'm going to say, okay, listen, account key, you have to go start using the key vault, select your key vault, and what is your secret name? My secret name for the blob was this. I don't have a version. I'm gonna test it, and everything is okay. So the next step is that we have to assign that key vault also to our SQL engine, that we can connect key vault, the secret name, and we're gonna test. And as you can see, it is working. So I have now assigned my two key vaults. And I can go back to the presentation, and we will go to the next thing. So back to the demo. So what we have done, we have created our key vault, and we have created the relations with the Data Factory to our linked services. So the next step is that we need to deploy everything to our next environment with the use of Azure DevOps. So what we need to do within Azure DevOps, we need to create a couple of environments. So you can do that by creating acceptance, production, and test environment in your libraries. And there you can define a prefixed variables to use later on in your release pipelines. So you can see we have only have to define the correct resource group, the data factory name for test, and what is the datap variable. In this case, it's this test. And if you're going to use production, it will be production. The next step is that we have to create a release in Azure DevOps. So creating that release is very simple. We just have to assign an artifact. We have to create that release. We will start with an empty job. We have to create a state for each environment. And once we have created that state, so like for test, acceptance, or production, we can start building and we're connecting an artifact, and in this case we will connect to the project, and the source will be in this case SQL Bits, and our default branch will be ADF publish. Yes, I know there are a lot of extensions also in the marketplace to do this, but I'm just using the default code within Azure DevOps. And we can enable the continuous deployment. So that means every time you save some or publish something in your Azure Data Factory environment, it will be published to your Azure DevOps environment. And if you enable this option, it will automatically deploy your code to your test environment. And very important there that you have to include which branch, because if you include also your master branch, then it will also be triggered on your master branch, and that's not necessary. The last step is that we need to define an agent. You can just leave it on the Visual Studio 27 default image, and you can use a hosted pipeline, so that will cost you nothing. And the next step is, once we have created that stage, we have to add a task in the release, and that will be done through a resource group deployment. And once you have opened that, you have to define your subscription, the resource group, the location, and in the last two steps, you're going to use the template and the template parameters. That's why it's the code I showed you in the beginning, the two templates. And you can just easily assign them. Then we need to override some template parameters. Hopefully some people have seen this before, how this is working. But otherwise, I will show you in demo how we can change that. And then we make it a little bit variable, like you can see on the screen, to make it dynamically working. So we can also use this for our acceptance or our production environment. The next step is that we need to connect our release to our library, so that the library knows which variable it needs to use within the previous values. Then we can still define a release name, format, whatever you want. And once we have clicked on test or to start it, we can test our stages and to see if it will deploy to test or even go to production. And then you just have to wait until everything is finished. And once everything is finished, you will see that your test environment is succeeded. And if you enable also a production environment, you can define a kind of a gate. And what does it mean? Before you need to go to production, you will get an email that you have to approve that release to production. And you will see a screen like this that you have to get the approval. And once you have done that, it will be deployed to production. So I think it's time to get some to do some demos to connect everything to our DevOps environment. So in this case, we need to go back to the demo site, and we are going to do some stuff in our DevOps environment. So what I explained to you, you will see that I have already created some environments. So in this case, I've created the test environment. You will see the resource group name, my data factory name, and my environment variable. So the next step is that we have to create a release. So we create a release. We need to create it over here. We need to create a new release pipeline. My fault. We start with an empty job. We call it, for example, test as the first stage name. And then we will add that artifact. So that's actually the ADF publish branch. So I'm going to the Azure repo, my project, what I explained to you before, demo DevOps, the repository. I'm going to select SQL bits. And I'm going to select the ADF publish branch, and then you will see that I can add that one. I'm going to save. And what I forgot before, when you have done this, you need to publish everything, because otherwise your template doesn't know that you have added that key vault and added that secrets. Sorry for that. So now we have created that SQL bits. I can enable continuous deployment trigger. I can add that filter on a specified branch, ADF publish, and we're done. For the moment, I'm going to switch it off, because otherwise, every time when we do something, it will be deploying, and I can show you what is happening. So now we are going to create that release pipeline. What will happen? So I explained to you, we can have an agent and leave it just on that Visual Studio 27 machine that will work enough. We will add a task and we're going to search for the resource group. Where it is. Looks like the name has changed. Don't know. ARM template deployment. Okay. Sorry for that. So the resource connection manager. So that was this one, my subscription. The resource group, I'm going to deploy everything to the test environment. The location is West Europe. And then we are arrived at the template parameters, what I just explained to you. So now I'm going to that SQL Bits repository and I'm going to select that template for the factory. I'm going to also select the parameters and the trick will come now, because on the moment, like if I click on that one, you will see I can override all these variables. So my factory name is not DVLM, but it will be $dtap, and that same code I'm going to use also over here. So it makes sure that it will be dynamically. So even if I'm going to copy this release, the only thing I need to change is the library. And I can leave the Azure Key Vault what it is. So I'm going to click on OK. So the next step is that I have to assign that variable group. I'm going to link that one and I'm going to link the test environment to my test stage. Then I can define the SQL Bits release, whatever I want to release over there. I can save it and hopefully everything is working now. So what we can do, we can create a release and to check if everything is in there. So before I do that, I'm going to the test environment and you will see that it will create. I'm going to my DevOps environment. I'm gonna create that pipeline. I'm going to run that pipeline, just add a trigger now to see if the data is getting in, and I'm going to release this pipeline. So the release SQL Bits as one has been created. It's manually triggered, it's queued. If I go to the logs, you will see that the jobs will start. In the meantime, I'm checking if my pipeline has executed. You see it is working. We can go back to our blob, to our containers, and to see worldwide and borders. And you will see that we have a file created from the data that I did this, created this demo. Going to check my artifact. As you can see, it's deploying. Deployment has started. I have to wait a little bit. And everything is finished. So what I can do now, I can go back to my data factory in dev, check everything if everything is set up correctly. So I still have the pipelines. But the most important thing is, does it look to other sentences? So this is the same at the key vault, and you will see that I have a test over here, and for the that one I have a test as well. What I can do now is I can go back to that pipeline, add a trigger now. Just checking if this is running. We can go to our blob storage in here, containers, worldwide importers, and the file is not there. I need to have some patience. Should get to wake up or something. Well, it's failed. So it looks like that I don't have the correct access for my Azure Key Vault in here. That means what I forgot, that's good. I have to say a listen for that policies. Sorry for that. But I did it on purpose. I also have to select my test environment. So that means that I need to create that grant access, what I just explained to you before, add, and I will save that. And I'm going back to my test environment and run that pipeline again. And you will see now that if I go to my link services, that this one is working correctly. You see, and that means that if I go back to my monitor, the pipeline will run as well. I have to get some patience, looks like. Don't know what's happening. Okay, succeeded. So going back to here, refresh, and you will see that I have the file here. Whew. Luckily. So everything is working fine. So I'm going back to my my presentation. What we have done so far is that we have created these Key Vault data factories. We have created the connections now as well through DevOps to our SQL database and to our blob storage, and they're also integrated with the Azure Key Vault environment. Is that everything? No, that's not everything, of course. The next step is we can also use custom parameters, because not all properties are set by default in the file. So if I want to use, for example, a data lake, I need to add some parameters in that in a specific file. It's called the ARM template parameter definition file, and it needs to be really like that. And you can download the file from the link below. For example, we want to add the account key for data lake, because that's not a default parameter within Azure Data Factory to Azure DevOps. And for that, we need some secrets to define. And there are a couple of options. If I'm just going to click, we have some properties on the right side, and you will see that I have the account key over there. And that means if I use a bit of secrets from Azure Key Vault, I'm going to add that account key to that file. And with a pipe sign, it means it is a secret. The other values are keep the default value, don't keep the default value, and the other one is the special case for the secrets file. So I'm going to show you that in a while in the demo. Is everything working fine? No, you have to take care of a couple of things. Make sure if you're using SSGS integration runtime, your SSGS, it cannot be run. So what you need to do, if you want to deploy something to your test environment and your SSGS is running, make sure you create a PowerShell script that will stop your integration runtime, do the deployment, and then start your integration runtime again. That's the same for triggers. You need to stop the triggers before you can deploy to the next environment, and then you have to create or enable these triggers afterwards again. And every time you change something to your connection, you need to update the template parameter file as well. And how that is working, I will show you a little bit later on in the demo as well. And all the deletes are handled manually or through a PowerShell script, which you can use, or a marketplace extension. So if I create, for example, connection to Google in my data factory, and then I deploy everything to test, and then I remove that connection in dev again, then I have to do it manually on the other side or with the PowerShell script. And that PowerShell script can be downloaded as well from the resource below. And if you get really, really large data factory environment, make sure that you're going to use the linked resource manager template. And that means that your template is split up in more templates. But I can show you that as well. And how we can handle deletes, I will show you as well. We can use a PowerShell script, and that PowerShell script you will add in the front, so a kind of a pre-deployment. So it will first check what's in there, then it will do the deployment, and then at the end it will delete everything what's not in there. And that also the PowerShell is on the same link I just showed you before. So we're gonna make another demo. This is going to be one of my last demos. So I'm going to switch screens again. And in this case, I'm going to create a new DevOps or a new data lake connection within my development environment. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to my linked services. I'm going to create a new data lake. So I'm going to look storage. And I'm going to look data lake gen 2. I'm going to continue. It's what I explained to you before. Linked servers, Azure data lake store, underscore, whatever it's called. It's in this case, I think data lake store 2. Auto resolve the account key from the subscription data and AI storage account demo. The data lake store. And I'm going to test that one, and you see everything is working fine. So if I publish this, and I only want to use that account key to deploy. So first I'm going to my data lake again. I'm going to say, listen, please use Azure Key Vault, the Key Vault name. Oh, secret. Oh yeah, that's cool. I need to add that secret as well. So going back to my secrets, I'm going to add that. I've prepared that in advance. So I'm going to generate a new name, and then I'm going to add that one as well. So I'm going to add the secret for the development environment, and I'm going to also add one for the test environment. Great. Development, and I'm going to add that key over here. Test the connection. Oh, cool, everything is working fine. I will publish everything. So if I go back to my release pipeline, I'm gonna edit that one, the job. I'm going to here, I'm gonna select. Now you will see that I have a data lake store, but I have only the connection over here like this, and I want to have an account key over there. So what do I need to do? I have to go to my repo. I have to go to my master. And what I will do, I will upload a file to that repository. So I will upload a file, and that's the file what I just explained to you. So the ARM template parameter definition file, open, commit, And now you will see that I have all properties over here, which I can use. I'm going back to my Data Factory environment. And the only thing I need to do is to click on publish. And you will see there is nothing to publish, but actually this means that your ARM template definition file has been read. Okay, and this is a new option. I can now parameterize the template over here instead of directly in DevOps. So what I can do in here, I can say add a template, and I have to add that account key somewhere over here. And in the beginning, I made a mistake. I didn't understand that pretty well, but what do you need to add over there? If you go back to the JSON file from that data lake store, you will see that the account key, that one, so with the capital K, that's the one you need to add, and not with a small K or a capital A, no, exactly this name, and then we can create a proper parameter from it. So, okay, I'm going to the template, I'm going to add that one, I'm going to go to here, add, so to a point, and what is the definition? The definition is that pipeline, and that means please use a key vault secret for every object with an account key. So I click on OK. I'm gonna publish everything. Once again, you don't see that there is any change. Going to the ARM plan, to the release pipeline again. I'm gonna edit that one. And you will see that I only have to don't know why it is not opening. Okay, it's opening now. Going back to the override of the template parameters, and you will see that I have an option to add that key over here. So again, DevLM, I'm gonna say dtab. And also here, I have to add the URI from the key from the data lake store, so that's from the test access keys. So that's that one, yeah. So normally, what I do, I am always copying it from here. That's the easiest one. So I'm going to here data lake store, and I'm going to make that a variable as well. DVLM pipeline, I'm gonna add that one, and I'm gonna change here also this variable. Dollar dtab dollar, and I'm now gonna save it again. Okay, and I'm gonna create that release again, and then we will see if that release has been created and if the data lake store exists also now in our development environment. I'm going back to releases, and I was going to show you how you can handle the pre-deployment. So what is happening in here? This script, I can show you the script as well. Give me 2 seconds. Let me see if I can put it on the screen. You will see the script will use it will first get all the dependencies, it will check the functions, and it will get all the data from your test environment, and it will be compared with your test with your development environment, and then it will be used in here. Then it will deploy, and once it is done, it will also enable again your triggers to run your process. So hopefully the release is finished now. As you can see, it's finished. succeed it, as you can see. So if I go back to my test environment and I click on that one and I refresh, I should have the linked service in here, and that linked service should point to the test secret name with the keyword, and it should also have that changed in here. If I test it, it's working. So great to see. Going back to here, yeah, you're not going to believe it, but I'm finished. So if you have questions, please feel free to ask them, and or send me an email, or search me on Twitter or LinkedIn and ask me the questions over there. And otherwise, hopefully you have a great day tomorrow, and have a great evening. Thank you very much.